Okay, so I was going to have Rusty Michelle pick a stand-up performer from today, but unfortunately, there is no stand-up performer. At this point in the competition, I feel like you're all stand-up performers. You wouldn't be where you are today if you weren't. So to celebrate, there's a little surprise back at the lot for you. So congratulations, because you all deserve it.
We're all very excited that we're gonna have a surprise at the loft.
Thank you so much.
Remember, this is a competition, and I have information on your next audition right here.
Yeah.
For your next audition in front of the judges, you'll be putting your triple threat skills to the test by performing an intricate section of the song, What You Want.
Yes.
Let's take a look.
What you want, what you want.
Bell rocks, and What You Want is a very involved song. It's probably one of the craziest high-energy songs in the whole show. The stakes are pretty high. This is a tough audition piece, and I'm really gonna have to give it my all and really prove to the judges I have it.
Wow, it looks like you guys have a lot to learn based off that tape. Remember, after your next audition for the judges, one of you will be going home. So learn your sheet music, work hard, and good luck.
Thank you.
See you later. Enjoy your surprise at the loft.
Us girls could not wait to get back to the loft to see what our surprise was.
Oh my God!
Oh, there's this beautiful table setting with four perfect little place settings, four bouquets of flowers. It just looks gorgeous.
Good evening, ladies.
Good evening.
Kelly's running for a special with you guys tonight.
I was so excited. I was like, ah, a pretty dinner.
Your chicken's good.
So after our salads, we got this great chicken dish. We also got some beautiful desserts. Everything tasted amazing.
It is.
Really good.
Yeah, very special bit.
Our waiter came to us and had a silver platter above his head, and there were four blue boxes. Everyone knows what those robin egg blue boxes mean. They're obviously jewelry from Tiffany's.
Oh my God.
Not only is it Tiffany's necklace, it's an L necklace.
My Broadway wrap gift came in a little blue box, so I wanted to give you something special too, XO Haley. P.S. Jerry gave the same to the entire cast on opening night.
Elle's always known for her Tiffany necklace and Tiffany's bracelet, and it's just one more step to help you be more like Elle Woods.
So Bailey, when did you first realize that you wanted to be on Broadway?
At my kindergarten.
When I was a little kid, I used to sing it like in the bathtub, but I kind of sucked.
When I started musicals in high school, like I remember like the drums and like hearing it all and watching it all on stage. And ever since that moment, I was like, that's what I want to do. I want to be on stage. I want to perform like that.
Hearing everyone's Broadway story, it was nice, but ultimately frustrating, because I'm looking at three girls under the age of 20 who have no idea. When I was 19, I had the same dreams of being Broadway, and I thought the same way they did. Oh my God, if I make Broadway, the world is my oyster.
That was like my main mistake, is that I think when I came here, I just thought that it's just totally gonna happen for me. And the truth of the matter is that it happens for very few people. And then even once you make it, there's no guarantee that you're gonna have another show ever again.
Autumn, you know, she's a little bit older than us, and it kind of felt like she was, you know, being discouraging towards us. But I'm not gonna let that get me down, because I am here to play Elle Woods.
I know they have the talent, I know they have the determination, but damn it, I have earned it!
Just Dance, rated everyone 10 and up.
There they are.
Hello.
Well, we wake up and it's another rehearsal day. I was most nervous to come in just because of the dancing, the blocking, the lyrics, as the song I knew by far the least.
Do you guys have a good time with Rusty and Michelle?
Yes!
So we're gonna learn what you want, which is a lot of number. It's tricky. So the next 48 hours of your life are gonna be rather intense in preparation for this next audition. So we're going to the piano, we're gonna sing with Seth.
Not a personal essay.
No, an essay so boring and so much does not fit.
What you want, Warner, what you want is me.
Just watch.
Warner.
Yeah.
I heard it.
This is not a personal essay. No.
An essay so boring and so much does not fit. So we're appearing live right here, making clear you must admit that Elwood should join the chosen few.
That was wrong again, too. Those.
What you want.
No, I said.
What you want. What you want.
Weird reading there.
I may not have the best vocals in this competition, but I have the it factor. And if you don't have that from the beginning, it's not gonna work. And I know that passion just lives in me, and I can just help everyone else experience that.
Warner, in a different setting, you will see you're getting all of this plus a brain.
No, yeah, that wasn't right.
Watch that plus a brain, because it's like, it's so high that it's like indecipherable. You know what I mean? Like, I can't understand what you're saying.
Oh, okay. Bailey has the personality and the dancing to pull it off, but personally, do not have any liking towards her singing voice whatsoever. And I feel like if she didn't look the way that she did, she would probably have been caught before Selena.
Guys, there's kind of a tricky little military section in the middle of the number. We're gonna start with that, because I think that's the most complicated.
Yeah. So, our first step with the right foot, we're going to have one, two, three, four.
We started learning combinations here and there from the dance.
Five and a six and a seven, eight.
And then once we had learned those, we went over them and then we started piecing them together and putting it between turns and lifts and extra little improv moments between all the two. And it was so hard.
Three Delta News coming in from stage right. Well, the last one's gonna grab you and push you behind the screen and you're gonna do the quick change. Now, be aware, you only have 30 seconds to make this costume change. And you better put something on, because Broadway waits for no man.
It was really hard and challenging having to learn a song, learn a dance, and it was a lot to handle.
Hey, guys, you're doing great, but let's ratchet up the Broadway element a little bit. Special surprise, members of the Broadway company. This is Asmerette Gebber-McNell, April Berry, and I'm sure you remember Nick Kankel. Yeah?
We finally get, like, the basic structure of the dance down and all the steps and the choreography, and then Dennis has a surprise for us and introduces us to some of the people who are actually in the show. Your first reaction is, great. They know this show like the back of their hand. I've learned it for 10 minutes.
We have time for each of you to do this all the way through. So that's what we're doing.
Bailey is definitely a precise dancer. Man, she hits every move. But I absolutely know that when it comes to acting and singing, I have nothing to worry about.
I object. May I approach?
I really respect Lauren's vocal instrument, but she has just that much more growing to do.
What about love? You ever been in love? 'Cause if you have, you'll know that love never accepts a defeat, no challenge it can't meet.
Rhiannon struggles with singing, but I wonder if the judges will choose her based on just her, you know, energy and her performance and not her voice.
Obviously the vocals,
yeah.
Think about them and
we need
whatnot.
To work on some of those vocals there.
Yeah, that's good.
I actually wasn't even nervous about the tapping because I know I can't do it.
I feel like every one of the girls has something competitive. Autumn has her voice, Lauren has her voice, and Bailey has her dancing. There's just a lot going into this that I'm competitive with each girl.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it doesn't need to be a shuffle. It doesn't need to make any sounds at all.
Even if I just faked it.
Autumn. She worked really hard today, but I heard her say that she's just gonna fake it, and it's not always good to fake it. It's always good to try, because in the end, they're gonna want somebody that's gonna do it full out.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
There's a lot that needs to be done before our audition, so I just need to keep doing it until it's ingrained in my body.
Exhibit A!
I am overwhelmed. I just need to keep doing that.
Me too.
Really? If you think about it, this is not that hard.
I just don't learn the dancing as quickly as like Bailey and Rhiannon do, so I feel like I'm behind on the learning curve.
I keep doing that now.
Lauren and Autumn keep doing things over and rehearsing and rehearsing, and it's like, okay, you've got it. Now just calm down and don't make everyone else nervous.
There is where you see it too.
It's becoming more and more painful to watch these girls that you really care about start to get more and more competitive. You just see it in their eyes. You see the, I guess we all can't be best friends forever because it is a competition. We'll find out tomorrow who's gonna be the best out.
Just Dance rated everyone 10 and up.
It's our audition day. And I know that I cannot go home today. I can't do it.
I feel like the past couple of days, everyone in the house has been snappy and crabby, and it's all of a sudden, like, there's walls between everyone.
I just want to stand in front of you so I can't see you. Is that okay?
Which way are you
facing? I'm facing this way. I just want to, like...
I think Autumn and Lauren's mood and emotion in the house and their nervousness is kind of, you know, affecting Rhiannon and I. But honestly, me and Rhiannon are trying to stay tough and just remove ourselves from that situation and try to stay positive and focused and do our best.
See you when we get there, girls.
Bye.
See you when we get
bye,
there.
Girls.
Bye.
This is all getting so intense. I know. You can just tell, like, the mood in the house and between everyone.
It's not us.
Mm-mm. I got stressed out this morning.
You did?
Yeah, I don't know why.
It's just a really giant number with lots of opportunities to forget.
I couldn't even be in the same room with them because it was stressing me out.
I wonder if the top goes outside or inside. This is probably the most nervous I've ever been for an audition so far. It's probably the hardest number I've ever performed, let alone auditioned with, so it's a very stressful situation.
The thing that I'm most concerned with right now is the sequence, remembering what comes after what, where I go, how I turn, just sequencing.
This is the calm before the storm.
Mm-hmm.
The worst part is when they deliberate.
Because I was in the casting office last week, it does put me in a position where I know I have to do a good job, and I'm not gonna let them give me a reason to put me in the casting office again. Break a leg, guys.
Break a leg. I don't know if the judges know I can sing. And so I just need to get up there and be like, you know what, judges? I can sing and dance and I can do the whole thing and you're gonna love watching me do it.
Hi, girl.
Hi.
You all have your necklaces on? They look
yes,
so pretty.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Good, I'm glad you like them.
You remember your judges, Bernie Telsey of Telsey & Company.
Hello.
One of the writers of the musical, Heather Hawk.
Hi.
And finally, current Legally Blonde cast member, Paul Kanin. I cannot believe that we are down to the final four. This is so exciting, and one of you will be the next Elle Woods on Broadway. But remember, based on today's audition, at least one of you will be going home. And as you know, for today's audition, you'll be performing a section of the song, What You Want, with Dennis Jones and a crew of current Legally Blonde cast members. Dennis, guys, you wanna come up?
Yay!
There they are.
Woo! Oh, look at that! You guys think you're gonna be able to keep up with these Broadway veterans today?
Oh, yeah.
So it's time for your audition. Rhiannon, you're up first.
What you want, Warner, what you want is me. But you need to see me in a brand new domain. Well, it's plain, Warner, in a different setting. You will see you're getting all of this plus a brain. I'll meet you there at Harvard with a book in my hand. Big sturdy book, big wordy book, full of words I'll understand. And right there is where you'll see it too. Warner, what you want is right in front of you.
My pants were off, and I ripped off my shirt. This is such an important part in Broadway. You have to be able to change fast.
How's this for a personal essay? I'm what you want, Harvard. I'm the girl for you. And to prove it's true, we all flew here on JetBlue. Thank you. What about love? You ever been in love? 'Cause if you have, you'll know that love never accepts a defeat. No challenge it can't meet, no place it cannot go. Don't say no to a woman in love. Don't laugh when I say love. Don't think that I'm naive. Because even a person who's smart can listen to their heart, can listen and believe. So believe in what love can achieve. Do you believe? Do you believe? Yes, we believe in love.
What was wonderful was how much you were enjoying it, which is so much part of what Elle's going through in that scene. So that was great.
Thank you.
I did think when it started it was a little quiet, and I was just struggling to hear a little bit.
Okay.
Because well, you don't want I'm it really to sound here. Winded, and now she has no breath to sing. And I felt like you maybe had no more wind left.
I had wind.
Right.
It was coming out kind of quickly, but I had wind.
Because I still have the feeling that I'm afraid you're not going to be able to get through it.
Wonder what you want is right in front of you. It is clear. Oh, this is big. This is mine. When I did my quick change, I was given the wrong hat. It was too big, and so I was like, oh, crap. At that point, it was too late. It was just way too late.
Just Dance, rated everyone 10 and up.
Oh, this is me. This is mine.
I go behind the little board, put the hat on, and notice when I put it on, it goes whoop and falls down to here. I'm like, this is not my hat. So I take it off and look, and it says Lauren, and it's Lauren's hat. I'm like, oh no.
How's this for a personal essay? I'm what you want, Warbird, I'm the girl for you. And to prove it true, we all flew here on JetBlue, thank you! This is what Elle Woods inspires, everyone admires, and Harvard should too!
This is not a personal essay.
Not an essay so boring and so much does not fit. But we're appearing live right here, making sure you must admit that Elle Woods should join the chosen few. Harvard, what you want is right! What you want? What you want? What you want?
Yeah, screw it, made it better.
I know, totally.
What you want? What you want? What you want? What you want? Woo! I didn't have my hat.
Honey, throw that hat out of here.
I love that the hat, because perfect little Bailey had to be sloppy.
It felt like you were making it your own, and it felt like I was seeing colors of you that I've not seen in weeks, which was wonderful. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, Bailey.
All right, thank you. See you later. How's this for a personal essay? I'm
I'm what you want, Harvard, I'm the girl for you.
And to prove it's true,
we all flew here on JetBlue,
thank you.
This is what Elle Woods inspires, everyone admires her, and Harvard should too.
This is not a personal essay.
No, an essay so boring, and so much does not fit. So we're appearing live right here, making sure you must admit that Elle Woods should join the chosen few. Harvard, what you want is better, better.
It's amazing that, that anybody can get through it. You know what I mean? There's so much going on, and I felt like the choreography was right on the money.
There was a moment in the improv section when she's like in her own world that you were kind of waiting for him to blow the whistle and walk up to you and you're watching him. I just felt like you were expecting the next moment.
Okay. What you want, Warner, what you want is me, but you need to see me in a brand new domain. Get it clear, Warner, in a brand new setting, you will see you're getting all of this plus a brain. I'll meet you there at Harvard with a book in my hand. Big sturdy book, big wordy book, full of words I'll understand. And right there is where you'll see it too. Warner, what you want is right in front of you. It's clear.
What you want, Harvard, I'm the girl for you. And to prove it's true, we all flew here on JetBlue. Thank you.
That's legal jargon.
Exit A. Woo! Time for my cross. May I approach?
How is that for you?
I am beyond proud of myself.
Yeah, it's clear when it's in your body, it's 100%.
Yes.
I mean, there are moments you're L all the way.
Yep.
But then there are other moments that I'm nervous for you. All right. Thank you, Autumn. Thank you very much.
I have to say I'm really proud of myself. I did so much better than I thought I would because I really thought I was gonna crash and burn. I know in my heart that just given more time that I would be on par with these other girls with the dancing and that I would definitely be able to do it.
Well, that was quite an audition today, I gotta say.
Yeah.
I completely want to do a Frankenstein and combine the comedy of Rhiannon, Bailey's professionalism, and just star quality.
The freshness of Lauren, the innocence that Lauren brings to it.
And Autumn's voice.
All right, let's talk about Rhiannon.
Lumped.
She was ready for opening night. Yeah. At the same time, it's just whether or not she could do this 8 days a week. And
yeah, she was a little out of breath.
Yeah, she feels green.
All right, let's talk about Lauren. It's clear she can sing, but I think what was really separating the girls today is how young and immature Lauren feels. We're trying to cast someone who's a woman, even if she's acting like a girl. All right, let's talk about Bailey.
The hat fiasco was 100% in her benefit. It was probably driving her crazy, but we got what we wanted.
She won't always have her hat falling in her eyes to make us love her.
Yeah.
That was my question.
Let's talk about Autumn. She's got a beautiful voice.
My fear is she a leading lady? And it's frustrating that she hasn't delivered more consistently.
All right, let's do it.
Great.
waiting to hear the names being called out was so terrifying. I felt so cold in that room, and I felt so lonely.
I was the most nervous I have been since I have been here. I probably could have died from the nausea I was experiencing in my stomach. That was the worst feeling of my life.
At this point, this is all about me. It's the Autumn show now, and it can't be any other way. I want this just as bad as they do, and if I'm more concerned with them, then I should just go home.
In my head, I keep saying, don't send me home, don't send me home. I need this, I need to be here. This is what I was born to do. I was meant to be here.
Hi, girls.
Hi.
Is everyone hanging in there?
Yeah.
Girls, one of you four will be the next Elle Woods on Broadway. And based on what you did in today's audition, at least one of you will be sent home. Girls, the judges have given me the list. Today's list is very different. There are no names on the list.
Just Dance rated everyone 10 and up.
Today's list is very different. There are no names on the list. All four of you must immediately go to the casting office to face the judges. And unfortunately, one of you will be cut from this competition.
I was shocked. I was like, what?
I was surprised to find out that everyone's going to the casting office. We're all gonna be kind of fighting for our lives, and I think it's gonna get sticky.
Well, girls, I'll be thinking about each and every one of you, and I hope you give it your best. Okay, good luck. Go show them what you got.
Come on in.
Up in the casting office, no matter how good you feel like you did, it's just always nerve-wracking because right then and there, your fate relies on these three judges.
If the judges are really basing this off of a true triple threat, there is a great chance that I could be going home.
Girls, none of you have ever performed on Broadway. And the winner of this competition will not only perform on Broadway, will be a star. Autumn, you have nailed some auditions, but at other times, you keep disappointing us.
For me, it's frustrating with you because I feel like sometimes when you hit the stage, you kind of left your mojo downstairs. People are paying $120 for a Broadway ticket.
Yeah.
And they can't hear excuses or they can't hear, you know, I'll get it someday.
Yeah.
Bailey, you look Elle-like perfect. You might be missing the emotional depth needed to play Elle Woods.
Elle is a complicated character, and we need to see those nuances.
Lauren, your voice is Broadway ready, but your youth showed today.
I don't know if I bought the depths of Elle's emotions. And at the end of the day, I was just worried. This is a young girl. She's a teenager.
Rhiannon, by the end of your audition today, I wanted to run on stage and give you mouth to mouth. You were out of breath. Broadway's a marathon.
Okay, we've come to a decision. Autumn, when you're prepared, you are captivating. Rhiannon, you are so watchable. Bailey, when you're in the moment, you're untouchable. Lauren, you have arguably showed us that you have one of the best voices in this competition, but you just might be too young to play Elle Woods. Lauren, I'm sorry, you are cut. We just don't see you as the next Elle Woods.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure.
Thank you, Lauren.
I did want this very, very, very badly. It was a dream for me. And it's really devastating to see that, you know, I didn't get there.
I just came into this not believing in myself at all, not having any hope for myself. And making it this far, you know, I didn't win, but I made it farther than I ever expected I would. And I've learned to be proud of myself for the first time in my life.
Unfortunately, I have some more bad news. Jerry Mitchell, the director of Legally Blonde, only wants to see two girls in the final audition. Which means not one, but two girls are going home tonight.